Good morning everyone, my name is Brunali Dhiwar and today I am going to share a video on a sericulture. So let's start with the sericulture. So in this section what we are going to study is, firstly we are going to see introduction, then history, then taxonomic position and types of silkworm. So let's see one by one. So firstly, introduction. So what is actually sericulture means? Seri means silkworm and culture means cultivation of that silkworm to produce more and good quality of silk. Sericulture is include two part, that is first one is cultivation of mulberry leaves and second one is rearing of silk moth. How this silk get formed from that silk worm? So it is nothing but the spittle of that insect, that is silk worm, from which if this silk, smooth silk get formed, that fiber of silk form from the mouth of silk worm. We can call it as a caterpillar. So this is about its introduction. We all know about silk, that we wear a silk sari and other costume which is made up of silk. But have you ever wondered that how that silk was discovered? So let's see about its history, small history. According to the old Chinese legend, silk was discovered by the Chinese empress when she was sitting under a mulberry tree in the morning and enjoying her tea. That time only, accidentally, one of the cocoon just fell into her teacup. Of course, her tea got spoiled, but what she found was amazing. She discovered that she could unwind a thread from that cocoon, which was very smooth. She just showed that cocoon to that Chinese legend, and from there only silk was discovered and sericulture started. So this is all about its history. So let's see next, that is taxonomic position of that silkworm. So first we are going to see its phylum. So it include in a phylum Arthropoda, that it is having jointed appendages. Then next one is its class Insecta. Third one is subclass, that is Stereogota, which is having a wings. Division Endopterygota, that it gives all the life cycle, that is eggs, larva, pupa and adult. Order is Lepidoptera. It shows large covered wings which is having a marking on it, and larvae we can call them as the caterpillars. So next, it included in a superfamily, that is Bombycoidae, and family Bombycidae. Genus is Bombex and species is Morae, which is a domestic silk moth. So it's all about its taxonomic position. So let's see the species which are related or concerned with the sericulture. So more than 500 species of wild silkworm are present in the world, but not all of them are in use to produce a silk, that is clothes. So only some of them can be used to produce the silk. So let's see which are those species. So there are two family, that is Bombycidae and Saturninidae. And it include, Bombycidae include Bombex mori and Saturninidae include Erae tusser muga. Those four of them are common and highly useful silkworm species which are used for the production of silk. So let's see first Bombex mori. You can see here the caterpillar adult and the cocoon which is formed from it. Bombex mori is domesticated completely. It is not a wild. We can domesticate or we can rear it easily. Its name is arised from Mandarina. So Bombex mandarina, it's original name. From that Morai has came. Its family is Bombay City. It's indigenous, that is, its native place is India and China. Its culture mostly done in India and China. It produces white and yellow seal. You can see here this in pictures. Its larvae feed on mulberry leaves. That's why we call it as a mulberry silk. It cannot feed on other plant. It can only feed on mulberry leaves. If we say its adult are somehow fatty, and its main purpose is only reproduction, so that it can give more and more silk worm. It's univoltine or multivoltine. What is mean by that? Univoltine and multivoltine is, if it is a univoltine, that is, it only produces one generation per year. If it is multivoltine, it produces more generation than one. So it is useful that if it produces many generation in a year. If we see its distribution, so in South India, Mysore, Coimbatore and Salem is the highest region where sericulture can be done. Of course, among all of them, it is used in large scale as it is domesticated. So this is about Bombax mori. So next, let's see second worm, that is Erai silkworm. Erai, that word has came from era, which means castor. It is mainly feed on castor. Its scientific name is Semia Xanthia ricini. It's silk, somehow white and brick red in color. Of course, it is polyphagous, that is, it do not include only one plant, but it can also feed on more than one plant. That's why we call it as a polyphagous. Poly means many, phagous means plant. Castor is more prominent, but it can also feed kesuru and bark kesuru plant. If we can see, its cocoons are not continuous like a mulberry silkworm. That's why we cannot, it cannot give a raw silk. Erai silkworm cannot give a raw silk, though it is useful for other purpose, but it cannot give us a continuous silk. If when moth can emerge, that pierced cocoon can be used. As the adult get out from that cocoon, hence it get pierced, and we cannot get a continuous cocoons from this silkworm. Of course, it is multivoltine, as it produces many generation per year. And in the male and female, the color will be brown. Its color is brown, black, green wings it shows, and white abdomen. If we see its distribution in North India, Brahmaputra, hills of Meghalaya, Mizoram, Nagaland, Manipur, Arunachal Pradesh are more common. The next one is Tusser silkworm. In China, it can be called as Antheria pernil. In India, it is Antheria myelita, and in Japanese, Antheria yamami. So its common name is oak silkworm also. Among four, it occupies third position in production of silk. And China is the biggest producer of that tusser silk. It is also polyphagous, and it can feed up to 2 dozen different host plants. It doesn't depend upon a single plant for the production of silk or cocoon. As it is entirely wild, hence it must be reared on a host plant. We cannot rear it like a mulberry silkworm. If we say its female is yellowish brown while male is brick red in color, and its picture is of female, and it is uni and bivoltine also. That is, it can, though some species, some of them are produced only single generation and some of them are produced two generation per year. If you see its similarity with the mulberry silkworm is that it produces continuous cocoon, you can see here, hence we can use it as a raw silk. And its distribution in India, it is distributed from West Bengal in east up to Karnataka, through Bihar, Orissa, Madhya Pradesh, Arunachal Pradesh, and in Maharashtra its culture can be done. So next one is Muga silkworm. So its scientific name is Antheria asama. It produces, you can see here, golden yellow colored silk, and its host plant is soam, that is Michaelis bombycina. It is completely wild, we cannot domesticate it like a mulberry silkworm. Its distribution is from Himalaya to Nagaland, Kutch, which is a district of Assam. If we see in Assam also, its valley sericulture is done in the valley of Assam, as there is a ideal temperature for cultivation of silkworm, that is 24 to 30 degree. If we see, its female is larger and yellowish to brown in color, and male is slightly different, that is copper brown to dark brown in color. And Meghalaya and Assam is contribute up to 95% in Muga silkworm production. So this is all about sericulture. It's some species which are used in silkworm, and it's short history. I hope you have liked that video. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please subscribe to the channel. Thank you.